love getting wasted. I just love getting wasted. It's okay. I can say it. My parents know. The neighbors know. In fact, I'm wasted right now. So I'll tell you a story. When I graduated university, standing at a crossroads in my life, my mother said to me, "Mad, do something that you love. Do something that has value." And so I thought to myself, how much value is there in getting wasted? Fast forward a few months and I'm getting pretty wasted down at the dump. Oh yeah, the landfill in Nudgee. If you haven't before, I really recommend it. It's great. The deeper you go, the better it gets. The longer you're there, the more you realize that this trash, this crap, this waste could be part of a novel, innovative, sustainable, and immensely valuable part of the economy. I like to call it the waste economy, and I think it's a way we can all find value in getting wasted. Millennials, as individuals of my affliction have so affectionately been labeled, have inherited three epic lifetime conditions. The first, the rapid development of science and technology, a crumbling global ecosystem, and a fragile, disconnected modern economy. Splendid. So the question facing my generation is there a way that economies can increase profitability using science and technology while relying less on natural resources? To me, as a biotech entrepreneur and a notorious tight ass, the solution was obvious. I am part of a new global economy, one that is not only novel and innovative, but sustainable and immensely valuable. It involves a complete repurposing of agricultural waste for use in products of equal or greater value. In fewer words, taking one industry's byproduct and transforming it into the raw product of another. Now, this isn't my idea, not even close. In fact, a few companies have been integrating this concept for quite a while now. My personal favorite is Ecovative. Ecovative is a company in Green Island, New York, who use agricultural waste to create packaging and insulation materials. Ecovative take the mycelium from mushrooms and the plant fibers from seed husks, fuse them together, and create a material similar in consistency to styrofoam or expanded polyethylene. Ecovative's product has the capability to turn the mushroom market into the $28 billion styrofoam replacement market. That's 1,000 times added value and the eradication of one of the world's most insidious pollutants. Did we just dismantle an established multi-billion dollar environment poisoning industry by repurposing agricultural waste? Did we do it in a way that increases profitability using science and technology to rely less on natural resources? Now, don't be fooled into thinking these magic mushrooms are a once-off. There are an abundance of local startups and researchers working on turning your waste into gold. In Brisbane alone, sugarcane mulch into pharmaceuticals, rotten fruit into A-grade cosmetics, and coffee grinds into diesel, just to name a few. But, yes, that's right. I can smell the pessimists in the audience. You don't know what you're talking about, young lady. You think you can waltz in here with your iPhones and your face flicks and tell me that some clever apples can end ecological crisis? Well, that's sort of my point. Crisis need not be the obstacle of a profitable economy. Crisis should be the catalyst that pushes them forwards towards permanent, self-revolutionizing, self-extended reproduction. No, the fallacy lies in the assumption that the cost of profit is tremendous amounts of polluting waste, stagnating in our landfills and filling up our oceans. So, the economics of it all. Inefficiency is the enemy of capitalism. Old mate, father of capitalism, Adam Smith once said, "Any inefficiency that reduces profit-making shall be eliminated by the market." Now, I'm sure we don't have to resurrect old Adam to tell us that the presence of waste in an economy represents a pretty huge inefficiency, especially when the management of that waste is costing us $350 billion annually. That's more than the annual aggregate spend of the Australian government, or whatever they're calling themselves these days. Yes, that's right. Each year we produce 2.2 billion tons of landfill. Now, if my math is correct, that's about 300 million tons allocated to each and every one of us on the planet. Why do you need 300 million tons of excess just to mindlessly produce and consume? This is the hidden deadweight loss of your existence, and it's not going to stay hidden for much longer. See, this concept is actually something that's ingrained in our evolution, a concept that has driven us to the top of the food chain. Take this bison, for example. Back in the Neolithic age, we had the flesh for meat, the hide for clothing, the bones for tools, teeth for jewelry, and whatever's left, dog food. A contemporary may see this as taking one industry's byproduct and transforming it into the raw product of another. See, this concept is something we are so familiar with, but why are we so comfortable with avoiding it? If we just repurposed 20% of our agricultural waste in Australia, we would be looking at a total economic injection of $150 billion based off waste costs saved and new products created, not to mention the tremendous benefit to the environment. The 21st century has seen some of the greatest developments in science and technology, developments that will have undefined influence on our futures. Yet, something that perplexes me is how we as a society are able to identify something so abstract as ripples in space-time a billion light-years away, and yet we remain so stumped on the concept that by producing and consuming in the same unsustainable ways, we'll continue to produce the same unsustainable results. Here we are, happily sitting on the horizon of a crisis so unfathomable, characterized by inefficient production systems and endless amounts of waste. Alas, the problem does not lie in the lack of science or even the lack of innovation. It lies in the fact that it would take an enormous restructuring of the global economy to fix this fatal design flaw. We would need to reinvigorate supply chains that haven't really been altered since the Industrial Revolution, tackling corporations, governments, and social systems as we know them. Simple task, really. Personally, I think we are all far too complacent. We are due for a new economic paradigm shift. Revolution is born out of necessity. Agricultural revolution, industrial revolution, now it is time for a waste revolution. Now, this reality doesn't have to seem like some far-off distant utopia. As we know from our economics high school classes, supply is so sorely influenced by demand. We need to demand more from our producers and suppliers, demand they see the social, economic, and environmental utility of putting the environment above the bottom line. We need to invest in companies doing something with their waste, reinvigorating it back into the supply chain, because I can assure you, you will see the dividends. We need to support these local startups and researchers that really are just trying to change the world without the fuss. And most of all, we need to stop sitting on our hands before we let this toxic complacency become our demise. So, it's effective, it's necessary, and it's going to make us billions. So come on, Brisbane. It's a Saturday. You tell me what is stopping you from getting wasted.